Hello friends, today we are going to analyze the given beam using the moment distribution method. The given beam is two span continuous beam having the each support as hinge and roller, in which first span length is 4 meter, which is loaded to center point load, and second span is loaded with the UDL over entire span. Now first step for the analysis is to find out fix and moments. So for span AB, our fix and moment for A to B span is negative WL by 8 for the center point load, minus 24 by 8, which is equal to minus 10 kilonewton meter. Similarly for BA span, our value for fix and moment is plus WL by 8, so 24 by 8, which is equal to 10. Now for span BC, which is loaded with UDL over entire span, our fix and moment for B to C span is negative WL square by 12. So W is given as 10, L is 6 meter divided by 12, which is equal to minus 30 kilonewton meter, and C to B span is W L square by 12. Which is equal to 30 kilonewton meter. So first step is to calculate the fix and moments. Now second step is to find out the distribution factor. Now for calculation of distribution factor, we have to focus on intermediate joint for every beam. So here the intermediate joint is joint B. So our joint is B. Now B joint consists of AB member and BC member. Hence our members are BA and BC. Now the next point is individual stiffness as denoted by K. So for BA span, if we focus on this support, it is hinge or roller. So for the far end hinge, the distribution factor is 3EI by L, where E is modulus of elasticity and I is moment of inertia for the particular beam. So 3EI by 4, which is equal to 0.75EI. And for B to C span, again the far end is roller, hence the value is 3EI by L. So for BC span, our length value is 6 meter, hence the 5EI. Now after calculating the individual stiffness, we have to find out the total stiffness as sigma k. So our total stiffness is 0.75 plus 0.5EI, which is equal to 1.25EI. And our distribution factor can be calculated by individual stiffness divided by total stiffness. Hence our individual stiffness for BA span is 0.75 divided by 1.25, which is equal to 0.6, and for B to C span it is 0.5EI divided by 1.25EI, which is equal to 0.4. So for span BC, our distribution factor is 0.4, while for span BA, distribution factor is 0.6. So unbalanced moment is distributed through these multiplying distribution factor. Now take a note that particular joint, the summation of distribution factor must be unit, or we can say that the value is 1. So in our case, distribution factor at BA and BC is 0.6 plus 0.4, which is equal to 1. Hence our distribution factor is OK. Now let us go through the distribution table. Now for moment distribution table, we have to draw the span as given, in which joint A is hinge, joint C is ruler, and joint B is intermediate joint, and our distribution factor is 0.64 B span and 0.44 B to C span, through which we are going to distribute our unbalanced moment. Now for distribution table, we have to input our fixed end moment value. So for span A to B, it is minus 10. From B to A, it is 10. B to C, it is minus 30. C to B is 30. Now the first step is, whenever we know the joint moment value, or we can say that the end moment value, as for roller support and hinge support, the moment must be zero. So we have to first balance the moment at hinge support and roller support. So for balancing, we have to add positive 10, so that the summation of the fixed moment and balanced moment is zero. And whenever we add the balancing moment, we have to carry over half the value as balancing moment towards the near end support. So balancing moment is carry over to the nearby support. Similarly, at joint C, the moment is 30, so we have to balancing it by negative 30, and half of the moment at nearby support, which is equal to minus 15. So first step is to carry over the moment and balancing the moment. Hence, we have to distribute the value as 0, 10 and 5, 15, minus 30, minus 15 as a minus 45, 30, minus 30 as 0. So we have to distribute these moment along the calculation for the distribution table. Now, first thing is, we have to find unbalanced moment. So unbalanced moment can be calculated as, at each joint, algebraic summation of the fixed end moment. So here algebraic summation is plus 15 minus 45, which is equal to minus 30. So we have to distribute these minus 30 moments along the joint B at BA span and B to C span. Now our value is negative, hence we have to distribute the positive value, and this unbalanced moment is multiplied by distribution factor. Hence for B to A span, the value is 30 into 0.6, which is equal to 18 kilonewton meter, and for B to C span, it is 30 multiplied by our distribution factor 0.4, which is equal to 12 kilonewton meter. Now as the far end is roller and hinge, the carryover moment is 0. So this value is our distributed moment. If only one joint is going to be distributed through the distribution table, then only one step is required for the calculation of final moment. We need not to go through the acquire accuracy as 0.1 for the distributed moment. Now let us take algebraic summation of 15 plus 18, which is equal to 33, minus 45 plus 12, which is equal to minus 33, and sigma m at particular joint 33 minus 33 is 0. Similarly, at vertical column, it is 0 for AB and it is 0 for C2B. So these are our final moment. Now for the calculation of shear force, we are going to use same table as we required the moment at particular joint. So for the shear force, first step is simply supported reaction, and for the beam AB which is loaded with point load of 20 kN at the mid span, the simply supported reaction is for A to B span it is 10 kN. The direction is upward, so our direction is upward direction. Now simply supported reaction for B to C span which is loaded with UDL of intensity 10 kN per meter and span is 6 meter, W L by 2 which is equal to 30 kN at upward direction. For the next step we have to calculate sigma M by L for particular span. So for AB span it is 0 plus 33 divided by 4 as a length of span AB, and our value is 8.25 kN, and for the span BC it is minus 33 plus 0 by 6 which is equal to minus 5.5. Ignore the negative sign, so our value is 5.5 kN. Now out of these two value at B and C or A and B, one is positive and one is negative. So negative and positive sign is from the our moment. Now ignoring negative and positive, we have to focus the two values at particular span which is 0 and 33. Wherever the moment value is lesser, we have to add the negative sign at that particular sigma M by L. Final moment is 0 and 33. So 0 is the lesser value, hence we have to put the downward arrow, or we can say that the negative sign, to the particular sigma M by L, and another point is positive. Similarly for minus 33 and 0, we know that minus 33 is lesser than the 0, but we have to ignore the negative sign. So 0 is the lesser value of 33, hence at 0 location we have to put negative sign, and at 33 location we have to put positive sign. Now we have to sum up of these two value, hence 10 minus 8.25 which is equal to 1.75, 10 plus 8.25 is 18.25, 5.5 plus 30 is 35.5, and 30 minus 5.5 is 24.5. So these are the reactions for given loaded beam. Let us go for the final diagram of shear force and bending moment diagram. Now going ahead for the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram, first of all we are going to draw shear force diagram SFD, as the value of shear force at joint A is 1.75, so our value is 1.75 up. We know that there isn't any load between A to point load, hence our diagram is horizontal straight line up to the point under the point load. After that the value is down 20, hence our value is minus 18.25. Again there isn't any load between joint up to the joint, hence straight line, and 18.25 it is 0 at joint B. Similarly for next point, 35.5 is upward, and 35.5 value is upward. Now the load is given as UDL 10 into 6 minus 60 at joint B, which is equal to 35.5 minus 60 as a 24.5. So the negative value is 24.5. and then up to C it is 0. So positive value, negative, positive and negative. Now we know that at the location of zero shear force, our bending moment is maximum. So let us calculate the value of the distance x from the right hand support. So assume that this distance is x, hence the remaining distance is 6 minus x. Now using this similar triangle rule, we have 35.5 divided by 24.5, which is equal to 6 minus x by x. Now solving this equation, our value is 2.45. So from the support C, the maximum moment location is 2.45, where moment is maximum at distance 2.45 meter. So let us calculate the maximum moment as, now at the right hand side anticlockwise moment is positive, hence 24.5 into 2.45 minus, due to the UDL, the value is 10 as a UDL value, into distance by 2. The value is 30.0125, which is near about 30. Hence our maximum moment at location 2.45 from the right hand support is 30 kilonewton meter. Now let us draw the bending moment diagram. So first of all, at location A, our moment is 0. At location C, our moment is 0. And at the location B, if we focus BA span, our value is clockwise as a 30 kilonewton meter. And our answer is 30 at particular location. Now this final moment must be join through the straight line . Now after drawing the final moment diagram, we have to introduce the simply supported moment diagram, as we know that for the simply supported beam loaded with center point load, our maximum moment is WL/4, which is equal to 20 4 by 4 as 20 kilonewton meter. And for the UDL, our moment is WL² by 8, so WL² by 8 as 45 kilonewton meter at the center. So under the point load, our value is 20, and under the UDL, our value is 45. Now for the simply supported moment, if there isn't any point load, then the diagram is straight line. And for the UDL, we have to draw a curve, but at the location of 2.45 meter, our moment is maximum, hence our diagram is . So this diagram indicates the parabolic curve as the rule for the bending moment diagram for the UDL. Now we have to plot the exact bending moment diagram. So the final moment diagram line is our baseline, and the rest diagram, which covers the hazing part or which cuts by the simply supported diagram, is the final moment diagram. So hash path shows that our final moment diagram, in which at the location of 2.45 meter our moment value is 30 kilonewton meter, and the diagram is positive and negative according to the location. So figure shows the final bending moment diagram and final shear force diagram for given continuous beam of two span which is loaded with center point load and UDL over entire span with each support is hinge and roller as given in the beam. Thank you.